little bit more from the countryside.
But I expect here much more from Colombia than just a new victory of the left. As you just said, the big problem is the failure generally, except Bolivia, of this left. They played a certain populist game, but what people really expect from the left is not just these big symbolic gestures, revolution, whatever, but to provide a new model of social economic life. But not in a pseudo-radical way. What my main ideas is the following, that many leftists have this comfortable position. We cannot make a real change now, so let's just comfortably wait for the big crisis and for the true revolution and so on and so on. No, although it's impossible in the sense of we don't know how to do a big change, we should grab every opportunity to make some first steps. Because you know what should give us hope? The whole scene moved so much to the right. Take in Estados Unidos, take Bernie Sanders. Now people decry him as madness socialist. If you look closely at Bernie Sanders, his demands are what 50, 60 years were demands in Europe of a very moderate social democracy. This is not only sad in the sense that the whole focus moved to the right, but it also demonstrates that what the left is asking today are not some crazy, impossible things. They cannot say it's madness, it never worked. Sorry, 50, 60 years ago it worked. And for a couple of years it worked even, although I was skeptical about him. Look, Lula in Brazil. Okay, he made compromises and so on. But he did change many things, also for ordinary people and so on. Life got considerably better. So it's not true we cannot do anything and so on. I'm for the task of the left today, if you ask me, is a combination of, I wouldn't say radical revolutionary perspective, but the awareness that in the long term, for reasons that I always repeat, ecology, new walls, new class struggles, intellectual property, which means chaos in capitalist finances itself and so on. Capitalism itself, and everybody knows this, I'm not here a crazy, when people say to me, you are dreaming. I said, what am I dreaming? Look at all big corporate figures now, Bill Gates, Elon Musk, Zuckerberg. Even they, although in a hypocritical way, they are saying capitalism cannot survive the way we have it now. So on the one hand, the left in power should combine, again, pragmatism with clear long-term perspectives. We live in the times which will demand radical changes, which means that the true utopians are those who think, let's just play it safely and somehow it will go on the way it is. It will not. The problem is to combine this radical perspective with very pragmatic approach today. What, although he didn't practice it, also Mao knew it. Like, if we have good local patriotic bourgeoisie, which can do well, which cannot do just the usual robbing they do, that is to say, stealing your natural properties and exporting them. But some local industries, especially industries which feed, which provide products for ordinary people there, good export industries and so on. We should here shamelessly collaborate with certain type of capitalism and so on. In an efficient way, to do this carefully, but with an orientation, and I think the first years of Lula, even up to a point, I'm already more skeptical there, the first years of Kirchner in Argentina, Morales and my good friend whom I admire, Linera, they showed us the way here. Again, it can be done. We should always be aware that capitalism has many faces. Look, people say you cannot raise taxes, capital will escape. Wait a minute, capitalism in itself can... Sir, are we aware that in United States, how high taxes were 30, 40 years ago? And it thrived. It was the best era of capitalism, my God. A friend of mine wrote a book where he celebrates Richard Nixon. I think he should be rehabilitated. Listen, he broke peace with China. He was at the level of spending money. It's incredible. He gave more money for health, for university, and so on. And I really think that the fall of Nixon wasn't just good guys winning over him. It was, of course, relative good guys like Woodward and so on, all that. But it was Watergate. But it was at the same time clear that he went too far, even if his social politics and the establishment got rid of him. And the other proof I have is that the intelligent, modern, even if it's racist and neo-fascist right-wingers, they all very deftly use this failure of liberalism and mobilize working class demands. Their message of Trump is not just less taxes for the rich. It's also, I will be better for the working class than liberal Democrats are. This means that we also have a certain space here. And it's just to be in the right position, very pragmatically, but with the full awareness of where the world is moving, preparing for the big crisis, to do this, to slowly educate people. For example, if leftists take state power, I'm not saying they should introduce police state, but I'm saying you should be very careful trying to reorganize secret police, army, and so on. Not in a new totalitarian way, but so that you can rely on them. Again, from what I know, the model of this is Bolivia, where Linera made a pact with generals against rich separatists down there in Santa Cruz. But the main reason is also, you know, you in Colombia, the main reason I'm enthusiastic about leftist candidate in Colombia is that, you know, sometimes it comes from time to time. Even if you are a radical leftist like Alain Badiou, who distrusts elections, I don't go as far as him. I said, okay, most of the elections are more or less, you can skip them, indifferent. But from time to time, a moment comes where elections really matter, where you cannot say this is just another spectacle of false democracy. And this, I think, is one of those moments, because it's not only the right against the left. The right stands there for a certain way to deal with your own conflict, civil war with FARC and all that. And so it's not just about right-left, it's about a whole model of how you see the future. Is it the future of national reconciliation? Is it the future of new warfare and so on and so on? In this sense, Colombia elections, I don't matter, not only for the usual wrong reasons. You know that intellectuals in developed Western countries are a fake. They want to keep their comfortable lives. So, in order to feel authentic, they like to have another country where allegedly a real revolution is happening. It was Cuba, before it was Vietnam, Nicaragua, then it was Venezuela for some time. This would be the wrong reason to support Colombia. Colombia precisely is not this, to serve as a fetish for Western academic liberals. No, it's simply we live in a certain moment now with Trump, with new external politics, and so on. What we should be aware is that the old global world order, and even the one that Fukuyama was dreaming about, is disintegrating. And now we live in an extremely dangerous epoch where new models are competing. One is this, I call it Putogan model. Putin, Erdogan, and of course, the same in Pakistan, Modi in India, China, Singapore, and Trump now. This ideological tensions, even economic tensions, but within global capitalism, new authoritarian states. And this is, unfortunately, the global model which is progressing now. That's why I support Europe. I don't have any illusions about bureaucrats in Brussels. But obviously, if all conservatives in the world hate Europe today, Trump hates Europe, Putin hates Europe, I'm trying to ask myself why. Because in spite of all compromises, Europe stands for an ideal of international collaboration, transnational power, relative welfare, and maybe this is the main conflict today. It should not be just new alt-right nationalism versus standard liberal new world order. That one is disintegrating. The left has worldwide a unique chance to oppose this new authoritarian capitalism with its own model, which will still be more or less capitalist, but a much more well-state, social solidarity-oriented capitalism. It can be done. If the left succeeds in this, it will not only save the world, preventing possible catastrophes, it will also, and this is so important, demonstrate that the left in power does not mean necessarily economic catastrophe, because you cannot imagine how important I think this is. This perception of many ordinary people, left is good to draw our attention to injustices and so on, but sorry guys, the moment you take power, you screw it up. That's why Bolivia is important. No. They took power, they are over 10 years now in power, they didn't screw it up, my God, you know. And I see Colombia as the next element. And why it is so important for the entire world? Because when you have one, it's the exception. Now you use this expression, and you were right. Entire Latin America, it went bad, except... Now if there is Colombia added to it, with careful economic politics, but social solidarity and so on, it will become a model. It's not only one. It will become not the exception. It will become a trend. And that's why I think it's not only about Colombia. The whole world, my God, is waiting for signs like that. You know, there are miracles happening, like in Greece, although they screwed it up, but Syriza was still a miracle. For the first time, radical left democratically came to power. Podemos in Spain, it looks bad now. I think up to a point, Catalonia ruined them, you know, because like they didn't directly support Catalonia, but they were sympathetic towards it. It costed them a lot of votes in Spain in general. But still, these miracles should happen, and we should hope, and it's a realistic hope, that maybe next time in Colombia it will not end up in catastrophe. So again, things like Colombia, this is not just a local event in Latin America. It's a worldwide phenomenon. We live in an extremely, I repeat it, in an extremely dangerous moment where even in Cold War, it was less dangerous. Why? Because there were certain Cold War rules that everybody basically respected. And when Soviet Union made a move which violated these rules by occupying Afghanistan, they paid the price. It was a catastrophe for them. The problem is that, and that's why we have permanent tensions in Eastern Europe, China, in Chinese Sea, or whatever you call it there, that we are entering a pluricentric world, many centers of power. That's the great achievement of Bush president. He ruined America really as a world power. We have now more centers, even India, China, Russia today, maybe even Western Europe. But we don't yet have a new stable international order. And again, there are different concepts fighting. The dangerous one is the new authoritarian trend. And what these are my hopes for Colombia, that it will push, provide the first sign of that, not only in Colombia itself, but around the world between states, we need a new order, not in the strict sense of world order, but, you know, to have stable international relations, you have to have a certain rules of respect, stability, and so on, and only the left, I think, can provide them at this moment. So again, it's not just, I know a little bit the tragic history of FARC and all that. It's not only for you, for Colombians, that this would be wonderful. I think it would have been something that international community is waiting for. Let me give an example how international community is waiting for it. You remember when Trump was elected president, all immediately he got Nobel Prize for Peace, which was madness. He was himself.
Obama.
Sorry, did I say Trump?
Yeah.
I'm so sorry. Trump wants it now. Yeah. Obama. He won immediately Nobel Prize. It wasn't a prize for his real achievement. It was this wild hope, desire. Will he deliver a new stable international order? I hope, this is my wildest hope, that Petro, your guy, if he wins, that he will deserve really a Nobel Prize. Because again, his victory would have been a message for the entire world. So I think don't, and again, even if he doesn't win now, the left should get ready maybe for next elections, or again, only this type of left, more radical than the usual corrupted liberal social democracy, but not the crazy left, which introduces terror and chaos. This is literally the only hope for humanity. Otherwise, what will happen? Look at Hollywood, they know it. All these dystopias, Hunger Games and so on. That's our future if a considerate, very rational, moderate left, but still real left, does not intervene. So again, it's not as a racist European intellectual who is patronizing you, ooh, good, authentic revolution in Colombia or what. It's out of the utmost care and worry for the fate of all of us that I am awaiting the results of what happens in Colombia.
Okay, thank you, Slavoj.